Welcome to Kickstart Monday. So, hari ni Dalim berada di the third letter Bukit Jelutong. So, apa pun, let's intro. Okay, hari ini topik yang saya nak share dengan korang adalah positivity. Okay, semua orang kena berada dalam sifat ataupun sikap yang positif. Either your mind, your heart or your attitude. Okay, the first of all, saya nak share dengan korang apa yang Dalin selalu buat untuk keep on have the positive thinking. Ada kadang-kadang dalam masa yang tidak berapa nak okay, kita akan rasa very gloomy and very macam rasa macam malas je apa semua. But how can we get rid of those kind of feeling when we start our day? So, ni cara yang Dalim selalu buat. Okay? The first thing that I always do is actually when I wake up in the morning, Dalim akan, biasalah kita akan tutup alarm and bila Dalim tengok phone, untuk download and loading bila kita nak bangun apa semua tu, usually kita akan tengok phone kita kan. So, usually kalau Dalim tengok phone Dalim, Dalim akan go straight away to anything that is positive in the YouTube ataupun Instagram ataupun Facebook. Alright? So cari benda-benda yang korang boleh save, maybe positive quote ataupun motivational talk yang always that keep you always energized and positive all the time. Then besides of using your Facebook, Instagram and YouTube channel untuk tengok benda-benda yang positif, Dalin juga menyediakan jadual Dalin the day before of my macam malam sebelum the next day untuk Dalin check apa benda yang Dalin sepatutnya buat. So that bila Dalin bangun, Dalin dah tahu dah apa benda yang Dalin nak buat. So that you tak adalah dalam bahasa lain ni like kancong kan untuk buat benda-benda in a rush ataupun you forget something. So benda jadual tu you have to be prepared early so that you have your own schedule and you dah tahu dah yang ni nak buat bila, so that you tak perlu rasa stress and fall into the negative thought. Dah bangun tidur, obviously kita akan take a shower and wash, apa tengok diri sendiri kat cermin kan. Yang ni Dalim pun ada juga buat, di mana bila kita tengok cermin tu, memang dalam bangun tidur Dalim tak jaya cakap lah, semua orang muka pun macam like, you know, very like, bangun tidur. Okay, usually apa yang Dalim selalu buat is walaupun dalam keadaan muka macam tu, just look into yourself, that is the true you. So why not at that time you smile. Ini biasa yang Dalim selalu buat. Bila Dalim bangun je, bila dah pergi kat toilet pun semua dan tengok cermin, that is the real you, so then you smile. Dalim, bila Dalim senyum, automatically you can see your facial expression open, you exercising your apa? Your face and also everything dah senyum. Bila you senyum, dari mata turun ke hati. So bila daripada senyuman tu, you dah macam confident, yes, I can do it for today. The next thing is Dalin dah siap-siap, Dalin dah keluar rumah. So bila Dalin dah keluar rumah, Dalin akan berjumpa dengan ramai orang, termasuk benda perkara yang paling kecil pun for me is a very positive thing. Seperti yang ambil contoh, I pass through toll ataupun Dan punya apa, cash and go tak cukup, I top up. And when I look into that person, bila Dan bayar, I gonna say thank you ataupun terima kasih. Even though benda tu perkara kecil, tapi it's actually a positive act that you make that will make that person a day. Ataupun contoh kedua adalah when you serve, people serve you food. Obviously, diorang ada name tag kan. So why not you serve, bila orang tu dah serve you, cakap terima kasih, like contoh, terima kasih Najwa, terima kasih like Fikran or something like that. So dia rasa appreciate yang kita ni tahu nama dia. Yang dia pakai tu ada purpose sebenarnya. This actually a one positive act yang sebenarnya jarang-jarang orang buat. This is very very good for you to apply whenever you go. Okay, as your day go by, you akan came across situation yang membuatkan you berfikir ataupun merubahkan you punya mood. Alright? So sometimes when you gather around with close friend ataupun you meeting a lot of people, sometimes they tend to open up those negativity punya thought ataupun they try to channel you the negativity punya thought. So kat sini Darlene punya tips is that the lesser you know about that negative thought is the better. Bila usually Darlene yang Darlene practice is that bila dalam situasi ni kalau dia orang dah trigger something that is negative, like contoh dan bagi contoh talk bad about another person, I straight away try to change the topic to another topic. Ataupun paling worst is that you diam, don't say anything. And yang paling Darlene selalu buat is bila Darlene dah tak boleh cakap apa-apa, is that I straight away walk away from that situation. You know why? Because sometimes walaupun you mendengar this negative thought, you tak cakap apa-apa pun, you cuma mendengar benda ni digest in your head and you tak boleh nak buat apa-apa. And you even worse if you talk back about another thing yang boleh trigger the negativity. So keep yourself shut ataupun you just walk away from that situation. Right? Dah sampailah penghujung hari, you balik rumah. Alright, you balik rumah, biasanya orang akan berada dalam keadaan yang sangat penat ataupun berada dalam rasa macam letih sebab dah the entire day. So kat sini adalah position yang very crucial yang membuatkan orang senang sangat fall into negative thought. So positif yang kita kena train is that whereby bila kita sampai rumah, kita dah letih, when you think back, is actually you think back what is the thing that you dah buat the entire day. What did you already achieve for the entire day? Instead of you think benda yang tak elok, why not you think, hari ni sebenarnya I dah keluar, I buat ni, not bad because I already gained something. And even, hari ni I say thank you for this person. Check. Alright? So, all those positive things yang you dah buat, you install rather than you ingatkan benda-benda yang negatif. And last but not least, bila you dah ada dekat rumah, kalau you suggest, I would suggest you to remind that always remember who you are in that position. Kalau dekat luar, you adalah seorang pekerja ataupun employer apa semua. Tapi kalau you dekat rumah, maybe you are as a wife or as a mother. So, bila you rasa macam, I need to have this time with my kids or my husband to appreciate the family, the moment that you think like that, you straight away think that is actually the positive thinking. Kat situ pun dah positive thinking. Macam, walaupun penat macam mana pun sekalipun, I kena buat benda ni because this is one of my responsibility. So, last kali. Alright, before I say bye to you guys, always keep in mind you have to have a positive attitude, positive mind and positive act all the time. And jangan lupa support Darlene by like, follow and subscribe my channel.